Well,
we are standing by to hopefully hear from the current Premier, Stephen Marshall, at any minute. Look,
there you go.
Here we are, pictures of Stephen Marshall arriving at the Robin Hood Hotel, Liberal HQ. A beer in hand for the outgoing Premier. Swamped by questions, a huge media presence there as he hopefully makes his way to the podium to give his concession speech.
Ladies and gentlemen, a few moments ago I called the Leader of the Opposition, the Honourable Peter Malinauskas, and I conceded and I congratulated him on his campaign, and I congratulated him on becoming the 47th Premier of South Australia. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been an honour and a privilege and a pleasure to serve as the Premier of South Australia, a great state. I love this state, isn't it great? We came to government 4 years ago. We came to government 4 years ago, an incredible situation. Since then, we've had fires, floods, fruit fly, the coronavirus, bushfires. I think we leave South Australia in an immeasurably better situation than what we found 4 years ago. I genuinely want to thank every single person who has been out on the polling booths today, who supported our party over such a long period of time. I also want to thank the voters of South Australia who turned out today. I think it's great that we live in a country where we can have free and open elections. When I look around the rest of the world at the moment, there's a lot of turmoil. In fact, there's a lot of tumultuous situations and volatile situations in Australia too. But I feel very grateful that we live in a democracy where everybody gets their vote. And today, the people of South Australia have spoken. They've elected a new government. But it doesn't take away from the work that we have done in South Australia over the last 4 years. We came to government. We came to government 4 years ago, promising more jobs, lower costs and better services. The figures came out this week. We have record full-time employment in South Australia. We have more young people coming back and staying in South Australia than ever before. We've got the fastest growing economy in the country. We've got record investment, record exports. And finally, in this state, we have turned off the brain drain. It wasn't that long ago that South Australians wanting to pursue their ambition moved to Sydney, Melbourne, Brisbane, Singapore, Hong Kong, London, or New York. People can now find their dream job right here in South Australia. We've become a magnet over the course of the coronavirus for some of the largest national and international companies. And I'm just so proud of the way that the people of South Australia have responded to the coronavirus and not had it break them, not had it destroy them, no big marches in the street, throwing flares in the air, throwing bricks through windows. I'm just so proud of the way that South Australians have responded to a global pandemic. We come out of this stronger than before, and all South Australians must share in this fantastic result. Of course, after this period of time, there are many people that I would like to thank. I'll try to do it as briefly as possible. But I have been the leader of the Parliamentary Liberal Party now for more than 9 years. It's been an honour and a privilege and a pleasure to serve this party. I'd like to thank my presidents of the party, starting with Lee Davis, who is our party president at the moment, before him, the Honourable John Olson, before him, Steve Murray, and before him, Robert Lawson, and Alexander Downer. They've all served well. To Sasha Meldrum, who has been the backbone of the Liberal Party in South Australia, the longest serving state director in the entire country. To Sasha and to all of the team at the headquarters, I say thank you very much. To the people of Dunstan, who have elected me now in 2010, 2014, 2018 and 2022, I say thank you very much. I love my electorate. I've been out of it for some time with some of the complexities of what I've had to do with the coronavirus, but I'm looking forward to spending more time on the parade, more time on McGill Road, more time on Paynham Road with the fabulous people of this electorate. Can I turn now to my parliamentary colleagues? Can I thank my cabinet colleagues, in particular my two deputy premiers, the Honourable Vicky Chapman and also Dan Van Hulst-Pellacan? Can I thank the Treasurer, Rob Lucas, who departs the Parliament after 438 years, or 39 years, but it seems a long time, Rob. Thank you very much for your mentorship, your support, your counsel. I still plan to catch up with you every Sunday morning if we can organise that in your busy golfing calendar going forward. Can I say thank you to the Cabinet Secretary, David Spears, who's also been the Minister for the Environment and Water, to all of my Cabinet colleagues, to all of the members of the Liberal Party who have served over my time as the leader, my current party room, former members. Can I offer my congratulations to new members of the Parliament who will join us, in particular, Ashton Hearn, Penny Pratt, Sam Telfer, and I'm not going to call it yet, but I'm very hopeful that Alex Hyde will also join us in the South Australian Parliament. I love the Liberal Party. It is the party of choice. It is the party of free enterprise. It is the party which I think really captures the aspirations of this state and of this country. I grew up in a family where all four of my grandparents had only ever voted Labor their entire lives. My grandfather was a wharfie. My father went to Largs Bay Primary School. He went to the Lefevre Tech School. But the thing that my father taught me, which I think is the great dream of our state and our country, is that we do live in the best country in the world. And it doesn't matter where you're born, you can achieve whatever you like. And I've got to say, it's a great pleasure for me, the kid from Ethelton Primary, to be the Liberal Premier of South Australia. So I leave you tonight by saying this. Thank you for your support. I think we have immeasurably changed South Australia. We've put it on a new trajectory going forward. It is a very positive trajectory, and I've got to say I've never felt more positive about the future of this state than I do at the moment. I've spent a lot of the last 4 years speaking to some of the largest companies in the country around the world, and I will continue to do this because I genuinely believe this is the best place on this earth, the most livable city. It's an affordable city. It's a city which I think has incredible values and will continue to attract the next generation of companies to our state. So thank you again for your support. It's been an honour and a privilege to be your 46th Premier, and I wish you all the very best for the future. Thank you.
Well, I tell you what, at 9 o'clock, I did not expect to have a concession speech by the Premier. I thought it would be maybe later in the night. Absolutely phenomenal. And actually a beautiful speech, I thought.
It was, and such a positive speech from him, wasn't it, Chris? Always the optimist, Stephen Marshall.
I think it's one of the good things is to see people leave with grace. Few of us will ever forget, or it wasn't, he stayed without grace, with Malcolm Turnbull's midnight speech, where he basically blamed everyone but himself for where they landed. He did end up forming government, but it was one of the most, and then, by the way, we were all exhausted by the time we got to that. That's no right. One was in the mood for that speech that particular night. So it is always good to see leaders leave with grace. It's good that he called his counterpart. That doesn't always happen anymore, by the way. So it is good that he called his counterpart and congratulated on his victory, because it is a victory that is well deserved. I'll make this prediction. Peter Malinauskas will be an important national figure. He begins tonight as a South Australian Premier. He joins that group of Premiers, which, you know, with the Prime Minister, will run the country. But the way he carries himself, the sorts of things he's talking about, the kind of future he imagines for South Australia, And the kind of leader that he is the sort of leader that Anthony Albanese would like to be. So I think that Peter Malinauskas is beginning a political career this evening. He's a very young man. He could be around for a very long time. Mm.